In this video, we'll try to understand how we can write FizzBuzz logic in C#. Now, let me first explain you what exactly is the FizzBuzz logic. FizzBuzz is a very famous programming interview question which is asked during programming interviews to test, you know, if a programmer has the ability to code or not. To test if the programmer has the ability to write code logic. Now, many times, you know, you will find developers they are very good in answering questions. They are very good in theory. Sometimes it becomes very difficult to judge, you know, if these developers who are good in theory, you know, can they really write logic? For example, you know, if you ask them what is a delegate, you know, they will say delegate is pointer to a function. If you ask them, you know, what is event, you know, then they will have this nice dreamy answer saying event is an encapsulation of a delegate. So what happens is, you know, many times, you know, interviewers find it very difficult to judge from the answers that do these developers really have the logic to program. So this FizzBuzz is a very nice question, you know, which will help, you know, you to at least understand that, you know, does he have that ability or does he have that inclination to write a code logic or not. So the FizzBuzz problem goes as follows. Print numbers from 1 to 100. Numbers which are multiple of 3. Print fizz rather than the number. And numbers which are multiple of 5. Print buzz. And if a number is multiple of both 5 and 3, print FizzBuzz. So in other words, you can see over here. So 1, 2, so 3 is multiple of 3, I printed fizz. 4, 5, 5 is multiple of 5, I printed buzz. Duck, 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 duck. If I go down below, if you look here, 15, 15 is multiple of 3 as well as it is multiple of 5, so I printed FizzBuzz. Easy, right? Now at the first glance, this problem looks very simple, right? But it is not that simple, believe me. So what my suggestion would be to go and pause this video, try to solve this program yourself, try to code this logic yourself, and then come back and play the video ahead. So if you are really able to solve this problem by yourself, then you really have the programming ability or the programming logic to code. So go ahead, pause this video and try this thing by yourself. So this complete problem, you know, we can divide in 4 steps. So step 1, print numbers from 1 to 100, right? So we need to have a for loop, you know, which will actually help us to print these numbers from 1 to 100. Step 2, inside this for loop, you know, first check, you know, if the number is divisible by 3. So if it is divisible by 3, then I will print fizz, right? And the third step, you know, if the number is divisible by 5, so if the number is divisible by 5, then print buzz. And the last step, you know, if the number is divisible by both 3 and 5, so the fourth step, if the number is divisible by 3 and 5, then print FizzBuzz. And very quickly, you know, we would like to add one more step here, right? If it is neither divisible by 3, it is neither divisible by 5, then just print the number as it is, right? So print the number as it is, if not divisible by 3 or 5, right? Great. So 5 steps. First, print the number from 1 to 100. And if the number is divisible by 3, print fizz. If the number is divisible by 5, print buzz. If the number is divisible by 5 and 3, you know, print FizzBuzz. And if the number is as it is, you know, if it is not divisible by 3 or 5, you know, then print the number as it is, right? So let's start with the first step. So let's go ahead and, you know, write a for loop, you know, which will actually run 100 times. And inside this for loop, we are going to go and, you know, check, you know, the step 2, step 3 and step 4 statements. So the first step is, if the number is divisible by 3, we'll display it as fizz. If the number is divisible by 5, we'll display it as buzz. But if I go this route, right, you can see that again, I need to go and check for 3 and 5 here. And then again, probably I need to go and do a negation check. You know, if it is not 3 and 5. So what I'll do is, you know, The best way would be to create a variable here, and I'll talk about why this variable is created, saying str results. Okay. So I'll say, okay, the first thing, if the number is divisible by 3, then go and, you know, push this output in results. If the number is divisible by 5, then what you do is, you know, you concatenate the previous result. That is what the plus equal to sign is, or must be, I'll make it much better here. I'll say here, okay, concatenate whatever is there written previously and with this one. So with this variable approach, what is happening is we don't need to do any kind of check in this step 4, because the step 4 is already getting executed in step 2 and step 3. So because of this variable approach, we don't need to do this extra check over here. So if you see here, if it is fizz, in the results variable I am storing as fizz. If it is a buzz, then in the results variable I am storing it as buzz. But in case, you know, if the number is divisible both by 3 and 5, so it will go, you know, it will go via both of these if conditions. And because of this concatenation, again I am repeating, because of this concatenation, it will store both fizz and buzz. And in case, you know, if none of them is true, in other words, if this results dot length is equal to 0, right, what it means is I need to just go and store the variable as it is, right? And finally, whatever comes out from this series of if conditions, I'll just go and display that variable over here. So I'm going to just go and display these results over here. So if I now do a control F5, I think I should get the desired output. So there it is, you can see. So first is 1, 2, so both of them are not divisible by 3 or 5, so it is displaying the number as it is. After that, 3 is divisible by 3, so it is displaying fizz. It leaves 4 because it is divisible neither by 3 and or neither by 5, then the buzz, then the fizz. And you can see here on the 15th number, he is displaying both fizz and buzz. Why? Because 3 5s are 15 and 5 3s are 15, right? So that looks proper. So that was a very easy way of implementing FizzBuzz logic by using C#. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we were trying to understand how we can write an efficient logic for FizzBuzz problem using C#. Thank you so much.